The algebra of linear transformations is section 6.1 and topics in algebra by Ian Hastin. The central idea of linear algebra is the study of linear transformations on finite dimensional vector spaces. So these are the key terms in this section. First we have algebra over F. It's an algebraic structure. We are going to define it first, and then now we will be proving that home VV is an algebra over F. So that will be denoted as capital A of capital V, and we will have then minimal polynomial for any linear transformation T over F, and we are going to have the definition of regular and singular linear transformations, and then finally rank of a linear transformation. First we have the definition of algebra over F. So an associative ring A is called an algebra over F if A is a vector space over F such that for all a comma b in A and alpha in F, alpha into a b is equal to alpha a into b is equal to a into alpha b. It may look like our associativity, but it is not associative law because alpha is a scalar, a and b are elements from capital A, so we cannot say like that. So basically for an algebra we need to have it to be a ring. It should be a vector space and it should satisfy this condition. So how many operations are involved in this? First we have addition, and under addition we need to have five axioms: closure with respect to addition and associativity, existence of identity, existence of inverse, and commutativity. And then we have the operation multiplication. For A to be a ring, we need to have addition as well as multiplication. So in the case of ring, we know that it has to satisfy 8 axioms. 5 are already accounted here, and the remaining 3 should be satisfied. So 3 more axioms. And then now we need to have A to be a vector space, so we need to have the operation scalar multiplication. So for a vector space, we know that the 4 axioms v1, v2, v3, v4 should be true. So along with that, we need to have this condition. So 5 axioms are to be satisfied. So altogether 13 axioms are needed, and these 3 are the 3 operations that we have to have for A to be an algebra over F. So this is another algebraic structure that we are coming across. First we will establish this result that if V is a vector space over a field F, then home VV is an algebra over F. So that means we have to show that this home VV is a ring, it should be a vector space, and then it should satisfy this condition. So for which we need to define the operations addition, multiplication, scalar multiplication, and check all these axioms. But already we know that this home VV is a vector space over F. So the proof goes like this. We shall take V to be the given vector space over a field F and describe our home VV, all those linear transformations. So this we are already familiar with from section 4.1. Then we are going to claim that home VV is an algebra under the operations addition, scalar multiplication, and then compositional mappings, and they are defined point wise. Addition and point-wise scalar multiplication, and then composition of mappings for all elements in home VV and the elements from capital V, namely U, V, and so on, and the scalars are from capital F, the field capital F. Now to prove the claim, we prove the following. First we are going to say that this home VV is a vector space because it's already proved. And then we will verify the 3 axioms for home VV to be a ring. And then the third condition, namely alpha T1 composition T2 is equal to alpha T1 composition T2 is equal to T1 composition alpha T2, where alpha is a member of F, and of course T1 and T2 are members of home VV. So it is proved in section 4.1 that if V and W are vector spaces over a field F, then home VW is a vector space over F. So by taking W as V, we can have home VV to be a vector space over F. Now to prove that home VV is a ring, we prove that home VV is an abelian group under addition, but that follows from the previous subdivision. The 5 axioms are already true, so it's an abelian group under addition. So we concentrate only on closure, associativity, and then distributive laws. So first we consider this closure with respect to composition of mappings. So that means for every T1, T2 in home BV, T1 composition T2 should be in home BV. That is established in this way. That is, the image of U plus V and T1 composition T2 is the image of U and T1 composition T2 plus the image of V and T1 composition T2. And similarly, for the scalar multiplication, alpha U, the image of alpha U and T1 composition T2 is alpha into the image of U and T1 composition T2. So first we will establish the first subdivision. We consider the LHS. And because T1 composition T2, we know that composition of mapping is defined this way. So we have this step, and T1 is a homomorphism. So we have this step, and again T2 being a homomorphism, we have this step. By the definition of composition of mappings, this one comes. So that is our RHS. And the same way, if we consider this, by the definition of composition of mappings, we have this step. And by the definition of scalar multiplication, how it is defined, we have this condition, that is T1 as a homomorphism. So by the second condition in the definition of a linear transmission, we have this step. And then because T2 is a homomorphism, this step comes. So we have from here, by the definition of composition of mappings, the right side. So closure with respect to composition of mappings holds. And associativity, the composition of mapping is always associative, so that is not established here. And distributive loss, which means we need to check the two conditions, but we will be establishing only one, and in the same way the second one can be proved. So we consider the second one can be easily proved from the first one, so we will consider only the first. Now, in order to have these two mappings to be equal, we have to show that their images are equal. So that is the reason for any U in V, we consider the image of U under this mapping. So we consider this by the definition of pointwise addition in home BV, we have this step. And by the definition of composition of mappings, we have this. And again, by the definition of addition, that is a pointwise addition, we have this step. And by the definition of composition of mappings, we have this step. So as the images are equal, the mappings must be equal, so we have this. So similarly, the second one can be proved. So this shows that home BV is a ring. And to prove the last one, that is subdivision C, this is what we have to establish. Again, they are all mappings. In order to have the mappings to be equal, the images should be equal. So for any U in V, we'll have to establish this. First, we consider this term, the image of U under alpha into T1 composition T2. And this by 4, that is, we have got 4 equations in the definition, and establishing that your home BV is a vector space, we had this fourth equation, that is by the definition of scalar multiplication, which is defined pointwise in home BV. So we have used that to have this step. And by the definition of compositional mappings, we have this. And because T2 is a homomorphism, we have this step. And again, by the definition of scalar multiplication in home BV, we have this step. So finally, by the definition of composition of mappings, we get this step. So again, the images are equal, so the mappings must be equal. So from that, we get these two to be equal. Okay, then we consider the image of U under T1 composition alpha T2. So that is, by the definition of composition of mappings, we have this step. And by the definition of scalar multiplication on home BV, which we have denoted as equation 4, we have this step. And by the definition of composition of mappings, we have this step. And again, by the definition of scalar multiplication in home BV, the right side comes. So this proves the subdivision C. So home BV under these three operations is an algebra over F, and it is denoted as A of V. So home BV is also an algebra with unit element, because identity mapping is always a linear transformation. So home BV is an algebra with unit element, which we require. So hereafter, instead of mentioning this as home BV, we will be using only A of V to denote the collection of all linear transformations. So with that, this video gets over.